Colin can say. But before we start, I would like to request all of you to be all ears and listen carefully to what we're going to present. So, firstly, before we start, I'm going to introduce to you to our presenters. So firstly,
okay, my name is Imran, and you can call me Imam. My ambition is I want to be like Dr. Strange. Okay, because of what? Because he is so powerful and very clever.
Okay, next doctor, call me Matt Red Dentist. So I'm here to talk about colon cancer, and believe me, dentist, even I'm a dentist, I like very much about teeth. So I will keep quiet, keep to hard work, so everyone can use their teeth to eat quietly in very good.
So next, I'm your next presenter. I am Shazwan, and inshallah, I am your future surgeon.
Okay, relax. Assalamualaikum. I am Muhammad Faiz. You can call me Faiz. I'm your future cardiologist. I'm interested in learning and search about heart, and for sure, I will cure your heart and keep the heartbreaker.
Hi, my name is Ida Fitri, and I will be a pediatrician as I am cute like the children.
So we will start our presentation now. So the first one is the definition of colon cancer. So the colon cancer is a cancer that starts in colon or rectum. So cancer starts when cells in body begin to grow out of control. Nearly any cells at any part of our body can become cancer and spread to other areas. Then next, for epidemiology. So for epidemiology, the first objective is it is the first study estimates the incidence and mortality rate of CRC, or should we call it colorectal cancer, patients in Malaysia by sex and ethnicity. So for the methods, the first one is 4,501 patients were selected from National Cancer Patient Registry colorectal cancer data, and survival status was recorded. Age standardized rate, or in other words, ASR, was calculated to proportion of CRC cases and deaths from 2008 to 2013. And the results were, firstly, overall incidence rate was 21.32 cases per 100,000. And the highest incidence rate, as we can see, is the Chinese, which is 27.35. And next comes Malay, which is 18.95, and lastly the Indian, which is 17.55. So the incidence rates of ASR of CRC was 1.33 times higher among males than females, which is 24.16 and 18.14 per 100,000 respectively. In 2011, 44.7% of CRC death was recorded. And next is the overall ASR of mortality was 9.79 cases. In this case, you can also see that Chinese have the highest rate, which is 11.85, 9.56 for Malay, and 7.08 for Indian. And the ASR of mortality is 1.42 times higher among males than females. So next, I would like to invite Dr. Farid for his types and risk presentation.
Okay, again, let's see about types of bowel cancer. What is bowel, what is colon? Okay, bowel is more general type. We can call it as the overall intestine. But really, I want to talk here is about, specifically about colon. Okay? Okay, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 types of bowel cancer. This
types of bowel cancer is classified by its where or where and what the types of the cell that change or mutate and become cancer. Okay, understand? So that is why there's five unrelated colon cancer here. Okay, first is adenocarcinoma, which is the gland cell in our colon.
Carcinoma. I didn't know carcinoma.
But in internet, there's okay, this is two types, which is Mucino tumor, signet ring tumor. Then about squamous cell, the squamous cell tumor is from the lining of the colon, which is in the inside, in the inside of the colon. Then we have carcinoid tumor, the hormone producing tissue, sarcomas, and lymphomas, which is the lymphatic system become a cancer. Okay, see here, this is lymphomas. You see that the yellow one is nana.
Pass.
A dead cell of lymphatic cells. This is sarcomas, that's an example of squamous cells. Squamous cells is every type of epithelium cells that generate and become cancer. Called squamous cell tumor and adenocarcinoma or
carcinoma.
Okay. Then about the risk factor. The risk factor, there's so many risk factor, but I hopefully can explain to you as briefly as I can. Okay, first of all is age, because when we become older and older, our body function is become degenerate or decrease. So everything, include the colon system, become very hardly to divide. Then cause of the cancer. Then we have a family history, personal history of cancer, which is connecting to our genetic. More towards our genetic. Okay, age, genetic, okay? Then we have diet, tobacco, body weight, and physical activity, which is anything from the outside or what we do that can affect our homeostasis system in our body, which also can make or can cause a colon cancer. Then we have non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, or can say NSAIDs, inflammatory bowel disease, is a type of medicine. Just ignore it. So we have a polyp there. Okay. Polyps. Okay, about polyps, is the tumor or the beginning of the cancer inside our colon. We call it as the polyps. Okay. Okay, I want to show you about polyps. It's the most interesting one. Okay, that is a segment here. In our colon, there is many segments. Okay, there's in this one segment, there is many layers that form the lining. So there is here many columna epithelium cell that shapes like rectangle. Okay, then we have mucus here.
Here.
I didn't want to leave it. Okay, then we have double mucus. Oh no, it's wrong. Mucus. This is the bili. And then we have connective tissue here. Connective tissue. different, where is the blood vessel, and we have what? Hepatic, anything here. Then we have double layer muscle. Okay? So the polyps is bigger in these cells, the epithelium cells, because in these below epithelium cells, there is a stem cell that have the ability to modify into anything. Okay? Epithelium can modify into for secretion, contraction, gland. Just forget it. But it can modify. Okay. It can modify. Specialized for anything inside our body. Okay. So these cells will differentiate here and become this layer. Okay. Forming this layer, the three layer, the double mucous layer and the epithelium cell. Then one day the epithelium cells divide wrongly and forming the polyps. This is the polyps. It's not very dangerous, but it will divide and become a cancer. Destroy everything. Everything inside of our we proceed with another doctor here, very handsome. So thank you, everyone.
All right, Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Now I'm going to speak about the clinical manifestation. Clinical manifestation divided by really divided into two, that's our sign and the symptom. Sign is what the doctor, based on doctor's eyes, he looked to the condition of the patient. And the symptom is the condition itself, condition of the patient body itself. Get me? Okay. Firstly, the sign of colon cancer is first the patient lumps and there is lumps in tummy or back passage. That means the area in the patient's stomach will become a little bit bulgy, macam lengkung, macam dia bengkak macam tu. Okay. And then second is iron deficiency anemia, that is the blood lacks adequate healthy red blood cell. That means the red blood cell become unhealthy because of lack of iron in the red blood cell, and the patient will become more tired and short of breath. Okay. Next is tissue abnormality, and then the symptom of colon cancer patient is they will have blood in stool. Stool is the feces, najis. Their feces will contain blood. And next is abdominal pain. That means pain in the abdomen area, and then the patient will become weight loss, that is unexplained weight loss. That means we don't know why the weight of the patient lose. No reason. Losing weight is no reason. Okay. And next is the complication. Complication is different to the sign and symptom. Complication is like sudah jatuh di tipu tangga. Maknanya, that means the patient got being infected by the colon cancer, and they will have another disease will attack them. Okay, first complication of the colon cancer patient is the blockage of the colon causing bowel obstruction. That means the colon itself will be blocked by food that is not fully digested. You get me? Eh? Okay. And then it will become more hard, it will destroy the colon itself. Number two is cancer eating in the colon. That means the cancer will grow in the colon. Number three is cancer spreading to other organs or tissues. This shows the real symptom. That means sudah jatuh di tipe tangga. That means cancer, maknanya one patient got the colon cancer, and then the cancer cells will spread to other organs. That is called metastasis. That means the cancer, the colon cancer cells will spread to other organs and affect the system of the organ. And last but not least, the development of second primary colorectal cancer. That means once the patient got the first colon cancer, he or she will the probability of the patient getting second colorectal cancer is higher. Okay, that's all.
Okay, now we will talk about diagnosis. Okay, the first one is the colonoscopy. For this one, I want you all to focus on this. Okay, colonoscopy ni is a tube. Okay, tahu tube tak? Kalau tak tahu, saya tunjuk untuk